chef?
I personally would think.
I would think, right?
I would think. If I could think, I would think.
Well, there you go. That's the deal, right there.
Whoa.
What happened?
I bumped my microphone.
This is not a good thing.
Oh, shh. No, it's not, because we're live now. Wait a second. I can get my cables right. Okay. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, here we go. Wait a minute. You're already on. I got to turn you off. There we go.
Who's on?
Well, you were on, but and the picture in picture. I took care of it. You're off now. Here we go. Live from Houston, Texas. It's Ginger Snap Wednesday with yours truly running the controls, Sammy. Dude, looks like you are getting ready for cruise time. What is the story with that, buddy?
Oh, you
got another week worth of work, so get back to the controls, okay? All right, Ginger. I got him back. He's working now.
Oh, good. We got to keep Sammy working here.
Keep that bear working.
All right, you guys. This is Ginger Cook. I'm just sitting here.
This is a very energetic opening. you're full of it. Hi. Thanks for coming by. Got to get you a cup of coffee or anything? I just say, usually, hi, Ginger Cook here. I'm glad you made it.
What, yeah.
Okay, let's go. Here, okay, we'll try it again. Okay, here we go. Let's go back to Sammy. All right,
start again. Okay. We need a do-over. Do-over, okay, John.
Do-over. Here's a mulligan. Here you go.
All right.
Hi, Sammy. I see you're back, not at the controls, but watching over Ginger. Ginger?
Hi, this is Ginger Cook. We're going live tonight. How's that? Better?
That's so much better.
We're going to just start off having a fun time. You know, what can I say? This has been a really fun week. John and I have been trooping around Houston doing the craziest little screwy videos. The last one we did was at our service station. We thought, why not? We're trying to figure out how to make the camera go so that we go on our trip in May. We can be giving you great snippets around the country, but we're going to be driving to Florida, to Fort Lauderdale, and then we're going to jump on a cruise boat. And that was my birthday present, if you guys remember, that John got me for my birthday, was that cruise in May.
Oh, I remember that.
I remember, too. And so anyway, we want to make sure we have all this video stuff down before we go so that we can keep you guys in the know. In the know.
In
all right.
In the know. I like that.
In the know. So, that being said, I know Van Gogh is one of our favorite artists, and sometimes some of the things he does are a little more complicated, but occasionally he's done some very simple paintings, but you can learn a lot even from the simple ones. So don't discard this because it looks like, oh gosh, this is too easy, I'm too good for this, because you'd be amazed what you can learn from just copying the masters, because he was a master of color and design and so forth. So what we're going to be painting tonight is this was called Wild Roses. And it's very interesting how we're going to go about doing it. And we might even add a little texture. I didn't on our sample, but we probably will come back and add a little texture on the flowers and give it a little three-dimensional effect. That might be fun. So let's start by just giving a shout out to our friends and that are joining us tonight. We have our moderators, Kim and Lori, and
Who's Lori?
No.
You keep hiring these people I don't know. Last night it was Carol. Today is Lori. Who are these people? How are you doing this? I don't know them.
No, but we did miss somebody. We've had somebody we've missed each and every time.
Mainly Wendy.
Well, Wendy, we did win Wendy, but...
Sandra,
but we've been missing some people. And then they pointed it out, but their name escapes me. Okay, come on, seriously. Hey, the moderators, what they do is they keep the trolls off the channel, allow you guys to have some fun when you're chatting, and also you can use chat. They help us, you know, answer questions and also make sure that we see the questions that you ask. John Will is our moderator. He's the other half of GingerCookLive.Gallery. He's that lovely, handsome voice you hear in the background. And John and I kid around a lot. We have a good time, and, you know, it's all good fun. And, you know, if you've got a question, feel free to ask. Probably you put it in caps so that we can hear you.
No, not probably. Please do.
Please do. Yes, please
do. There's no probably with that one.
That's true. And then here's the other thing, too. We still may not, but if there's a question that's burning in your mind, burning question, like, you know, you can write and we'll answer. Somebody asked the other day, and I did answer. They said, how do you make, like, a buff titanium or a, you know, kind of a beige titanium? You know, you can buy it like this. Okay, which is nice when you want kind of a beigey color. I mean, you know, this is kind of cool, right? But if you want a beige color, it is white, 98% white, ultramarine blue, and a tiny bit of yellow oxide. Excuse me. Burnt umber, and not ultramarine blue, white, burnt umber, and a tiny bit of yellow oxide. And it's probably mostly white with those two colors, yellow oxide and a little bit of burnt umber, raw umber would work too, to get sort of this almost parchment color. And you know, it's nice to buy it in the tubes. If you have a painting that has a lot of that color, that can be very helpful. If you guys happen to see the painting we did, John and I, you know, have on Sundays, we've been doing a painting lesson with John, and this is in two parts. This is called John's Journey, Ginger Teaches John to Paint, and the gate was done with that color. Can you see the gate of that buff? Okay.
Yes.
And so, and honestly, this is, if you haven't caught this series, I've been teaching John to paint, never did acrylics before. We've got 5 hours in this lesson between the two. This is, and it's step by step.
How long does it normally take you to do that lesson?
Well, about an hour. So
the
reason that we're doing it like this is that John is painting at the normal speed. This is mine. This is John's. You can see he did fantastic. This is his fifth painting ever. Isn't that great? So anyway, if you haven't caught that, we're going to advise you to do that. Again, want to welcome everybody tonight that came, and if we have any other moderators that I have forgot their voice, you got to say, because there was somebody. She's got the tiger icon.
The tiger icon.
Well, maybe it isn't quite that, but it's an interesting icon.
I only see the normal three on our channel. So you there's somebody that I don't know then.
Possibly.
Oh, good, good, good.
All right, so I'll have to show you after, because anyway, so this is fun. So if John would be so kind as to put the camera down on the table, we'll get right down to business. Now, I took a little 8x10 canvas, and I painted it kind of an orange color, you know, cad red medium and yellow, made a little orange color and dried it, all right? Now you're thinking, why is that? Because if you look at the color, in between the colors, then in the colors that way down in here, this is the color I want reflecting back. And that's another, you know, a lesson that you wouldn't think you'd necessarily do that with. Now, the first thing we want to do is we're going to paint this in actually two parts. We're going to paint this in sort of a, almost, I think, a split pea soup green. And then we're going to come down here and make this dark green, all right? And that'll be fun. We'll make this dark green and have a two-tone green. So let's come down. We're going to do that, and I'll put some paints out. I have these labels here. If you go to our website and just ask us, we will send you the template for those. You just buy these at on Amazon, you know, or they're Avery labels, but we can give you the template. So, and then, of course, you could type in some of your own stuff, too. But this is very handy to keep track of what you're painting. A little bit of burnt umber, red medium. And why I'm putting these out, I just want to say, hi, John. We had some, we really had a nice crowd here yesterday, and we've gotten some beautiful pictures back of what people have been painting. And we really, if someone wrote us and said, what, you know, how do I send you a picture? How do they send us a picture if they want to just post on the forum, John? Could you explain that? Our forum? No, apparently not.
Well, next week I'm going to be doing a forum how to get to know our forum. And it'll be a live event, and it'll be recorded, so you guys can watch it later. And I'm going to go through the whole procedure. It's real simple. You guys can have your own album if you want to post a picture by itself and have comments specifically about that one painting you're working on. You can do that as well.
You don't have to be a member to become join our forum over at gingercooklive.gallery. We just thought, you know, the problem with Facebook, which we love, right?
Some of us love.
Well, you know, it's great, but it scrolls down like Santa Claus list, and after a while, everything's gone. All right, it's just there for a while, and then gone. You can't find it anymore. But if, you know, we just thought that, you know, some of you spend a long time on your paintings and are very proud of them, and, you know, you'd like to be able to tell a friend, hey, you should see what I painted, and, yeah, you can do your own Pinterest account, but we just thought it'd be fun to be able to hang out at our place, and so we're making a place for you to do that. But also, my Facebook account is ginger.cook.92 if you want to friend me and become friends, and then you can share artwork that has to do. Here's what I want to see on my Facebook page, because we get so much artwork, is the artwork you've either done on YouTube or on our channel, YouTube channel or on our website. That's, you know, I'm glad that you're painting your neighbor's dog, and I think that's great, but, you know, and your neighbor's happy about it, but you know, we're just kind of want to focus on that stuff on our Facebook page. See, what am I missing here? I'm missing some blue. And, yeah, the two blues. Well, I'm just going to start putting out paint, and then I'll grab some tabs later because my eyes are going a little cross-eyed trying to read that. All right, here's some phthalo blue because remember, we're going to make our own greens. And I'm just going to put that up here, caps up here. I'm just not going to fool with caps tonight. Caps are annoying. Ugh. Here's a little ultramarine blue. Put that out there. No cap. Sorry, John. A little bit of purple.
Let me know if you can hear me now. I turned it up a little bit. And also somebody asked if I practice between lessons. No.
No, John doesn't have time. He's so busy answering. John doesn't get to bed at night till like 2, 3 in the morning, every morning. And some nights, sometimes we're going to the gym at midnight. We went to the gymnast last night at midnight, didn't get home till 1 o'clock. I walked a mile and a half on the treadmill, which was I thought was pretty good for me.
I think it's great.
We're trying to, this is called Yellow Deep, and this is an interesting color. We're going to just play with that. We're going to have Cad Yellow Medium, of course, but I want you to see the difference. I was looking for that to, here's a Cad Yellow Medium. Do you see the difference on this palette? This is almost the orange yellow. I just found that. Thought it'd be nice for this.
So we don't have a label for that.
We don't have a label for that, but
Now I'm too loud.
Sounds too loud now. Wow.
Not me. We have to do something about a microphone for me someday.
All right. What would we do?
I don't know. I need one like you have.
Oh, that would be good. All right.
Yeah,
so Cad Red Medium. Yeah, I want that. Cad Red Medium. Okay, that's a good one. A burnt umber, and I don't think we need magenta, but I'm going to put it out anyway because magenta makes an interesting green. It's a very interesting green. So I'm going to put quadrichrome magenta out there. Canachrome magenta and magenta and burnt umber. All right, so those are our colors. That's pretty much our little gang, and then plus the white. All right, plus we're going to do white. And I don't know that we'll use mixing white, but we have it just in case, but we'll just do something like that. So there's our log of white. Now, basically what I'm going to do is take a piece of chalk and just going to kind of show you. I want to come up about 3 inches on this side of the bottom of my canvas, about 3 inches over here, and then about 4 inches over here. And I'm just going to kind of make a something like that, okay? You don't have to, just something like this. Not exact science here. It's fine, right? And so everything above here is going to be kind of that split pea soup green, and then everything down here is going to be a dark green. So to make that, let me just get that out of the way. To make that, we're going to just take a palette knife like this, and I want to start with the light green first. So I'm going to take a little bit of ultramarine blue and cad yellow, or yellow oxide, right? Make a beautiful kind of split pea soup green. Do you see that? That makes it, okay? Now, I want a little bit more translucent than that. So I can add a little bit more of the yellow to it, okay? And I'll lighten this up just a bit. And then I'll add just about 1% of the cad red medium to knock that back. And I say knock that back, so it's not like practically glowing in the dark, okay? So, all right, so that's probably going to be my color. It is going to be my color, not probably, kind of like that. Let me just test it. I'll take what kind of brush do we want? Well, we'll just take one like this. This is a number 12 ruby satin silver. Let's see, is that going to work? Yeah, that'll work, okay? So what we're going to do now is just sort of scrape it all up like this. So we're taking it off the palette knife. Now I want backward strokes like this, backward strokes. And the background is totally dry. We're going to go kind of, he did horizontal strokes back and forth like this. And if you want to let some of the orange show through, that's okay. I'm making this pretty thin. Okay, I'm keeping this pretty translucent-y thin so that a little of this red underpainting kind of peeks through like that. It's a really easy painting to do, but it could be very fun to do. And these are not colors that I would normally choose to do, all right?
Well, the split pea soup you've been doing, and you don't like split pea soup, so I'm
No,
really...
I don't like split pea soup, and in fact, I don't like a lot of foods that start with this color. what food, besides split pea soup, what else starts with this color? I don't know.
I won't say. The babies come to mind, though.
Yes, okay, well, no, but that's more of a different, this is green. Okay, I don't know. What did you feed your kid?
No, this I'm is taking what... up the from the top end and not the bottom end after they have a, you know, peas or something.
Oh, okay. It's you more than this, this mushy baby peas. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
All right, so now, you know, here we are. And if you want to just, I have orange around the top. You know, I just did that, but you could just cover your, you know, top here and your sides. You know, feel free to do that if you want to. All right, so this is pretty much, and then, and again, you see a little bit of that color painting through. And this is not complicated. I mean, pretty easy, right? So now I'm going to just put this, mound this up and stick it over here like this. I'll just pile this up. If you don't want your paint to dry up, scrape it up and then put it somewhere else. You know, mound it up. I don't know that you see me do that a lot, but I may want to refer back to this color later.
Okay. What color did you use for the underpainting?
Just an orange, just a, you know, cab red medium and yellow. And just made
that's
an orange.
Basic
just
orange.
Any old orange would do, right? You could just, you know, just some sort of red orange color. Okay. Now, we're going to put, I'm going to just rinse the brush off here because I've got that light color. When you're in a light color, this is important. If you don't, people always talk about how expensive painting is and that you can waste a lot of paint. But one of the things is you can't, once you start with light colors like white and yellow, it's very hard to get really dark. So if you're going to go for real dark green, you have to start with the blue first, and you don't want a lot of light on your brush. Okay, so I'm going to take the brush and water and kind of wipe it off and wring it out like that. Now I'm going to start with the, again, ultramarine blue. And we'll take a little bit of cad yellow medium, not too much. We're making a dark green color. Tiny bit of maybe dosing purple, not too, let's see, let's take a little phthalo in that. So I'm going to warm this up just a bit, little phthalo. I keep talking about that and then someone said, why is that warm? But I want to kind of blue-green it up a bit as opposed to more of the army green. I wanted to kind of warm up the green a little bit, so we're kind of a combination of that. So I'm going to say that in this here, let's see, let's put a little bit more yellow with that. Okay.
Do you know the official name of this painting?
Yeah, Wild Roses.
Really?
That was the name of it.
Boy,
it was done in 1890.
Clever.
Wild Roses. You should be able to find this pretty good. You know, this is pretty,
okay.
Pretty. It shouldn't be that hard to find. Now, we're going to come around here on the bottom like this using this large brush. And we're going to make this dark color. Kind of a fun thing to do. Do we have any questions while we're happily painting this around?
Yeah? We've been answering most of them as we're going.
Oh, good. Well, while I'm painting this, I'm going to just...
it's in your bucket.
I'm going to grab the dice, and we're going to play a art trivia game. Okay, let's do that.
What?
Art trivia.
Art trivia? What's all that about?
Well, we just called Stump the Artist, and we have like over 600 questions from this neat art trivia game we bought. And whenever we do a live class,
questions.
And we, you know, it's just fun to, you know, play. So it's, you know, sometimes watching somebody paint something in is like watching grass grow. I mean, at some point it becomes much less interesting.
Really?
Though I could tell you some great stories. We were talking tonight about some stories that we could tell you. Gosh, do you like that? See what I just did? Just stuck my hand in the paint. You know. Anyway, we were talking about some. People always like the stories of, you know, our household, right? And we've got some great stories. All right. So let's start with number 6.
There you go. I knew you could see. After I peeled that extra paint off, she was loading
the
dice.
We loaded the dice.
Loaded the dice. She had paint on it, so it would never go to 6. I caught her.
Okay.
Hey, somebody, Cindy Lou is asking, has anyone had a problem with Liquitex White getting gummy after it's on the palette for a little while?
Are you using retarding medium in it? Because that's the first thing. If you're using anything, when people always say, well, why don't you use retarding mediums and stuff, you know, the stay wet stuff, because nothing will make stuff go, you know, after a while it goes gummy. You know, you get, you know, it stay wet for a while and then it goes to gummy. So if you're not using gummy, I haven't had a problem with it. I've never had a problem with that doing that. So I don't know.
Miss Marie is asking, cad red light substitute. I have cad red medium, but not light. What can I do?
Yeah, cad red light would be fine. You could just do the whole thing. And
no, she has medium. You wanted light.
Oh, I think this was cad red medium here. Did I say light? Well, then I lied. I'm sorry. I'm just sorry. Yeah, it's fine. You could put a little bit of, look, you could add, here, let's just make this color for everybody, shall we? Let's just
what
stop
color are you
going to
make?
It doesn't really matter. It could be any old orange. Honestly, you're going to lose it, but let's just, she wants the background color.
Oh, okay.
So I'm just going to take some yellow, see, and some red, Now, there it is. Yellow and red, now I've got orange, okay? That's pretty much, that's the color, see? Pretty much it. Okay, I mean my yellow's not mixed perfectly, but there you go, there's a color. You want it a little darker, add more red. But they, so basically we're talking about something like that. Just everybody's monitors, you know, can be different, but there's your color, okay? So you just want some sort of orange color down there. If you didn't have that, you could just paint it red. It doesn't really matter. Okay, so then you're, all right, so I'm going to put that brush away. Get out a small angle brush.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Monochrome, polychrome, chromatics are all words that are related to what aspect of artwork?
Monochrome? Say the question again. You got to repeat it twice. Monochrome?
Monochrome, polychrome.
Polychrome.
That's what I said.
I know, I'm repeating it for you. Good.
So you're repeating what I'm saying.
Yes, so everybody can hear it, yes?
Okay. Monochrome, polychrome, chromatics.
Chromatics.
Are all words that are related to what aspect of artwork?
So what are these related to? What aspect of artwork? Okay.
Actually, it's for a different project that calls for CAD red light, but I only have medium. Oh, that's Miss Marie. They're asking for light for a project she's doing, and she only has medium. Can she take a medium and make it a light?
Well, I just put more yellow in it. It's close enough, and yeah, it won't be exact, but it's close enough, right? She can. All right, do you see when we come up here, we're adding
the answers are starting to come in. Zoe is saying color. Kim Sim is color. Sue is color. Sissy is black, white, gray. Photography for Marine, Deborah's color, Gail's pigment, Judy's color, Suzanne is the color scheme used in the painting. I see that, Suzanne.
So Suzanne is getting very specific here.
Ivan is saying color, Joan is saying color, Lily's saying color, Kathleen's saying color, color theme from Beverly. Isn't like colors in color? Marine's right. Color, Corey's color. What's Ginger say?
All right, Ginger wants to just explain a little something. As I come up, I'm going to have a flower right here.
She's avoiding
right?
the answer.
No, I just have a flower right here. So I'm putting a few individual petals up as we go up here. Do you see that? So the top edge, we're just sort of adding some different petals. And I'm running out of paint. I want to make sure I mix enough of this color. All right, so.
Oh, Becky, you have a clue. She said no clue.
I think it has to do with color. I would say it has to do with color.
It's all colors.
It's all colors. They're all colors for the painting.
Monochrome's two color. Poly, I think, is five. Isn't poly five?
Okay. Have you ever heard this thing? You know, what do you call somebody that speaks two languages?
Bilingual.
Uh-huh. What about three languages?
Trilingual.
What about, say, 12 or 13 languages?
A crazy person.
A polyglot.
A polyglot.
Uh-huh. What do you call someone that speaks one language? An American.
I was going to say, me.
American. An American. Do you love that?
American. You don't speak English, we don't talk it. Polychrome. Oh, that's not really what it is.
All right. What was the answer, John?
Color.
All right, so I had to do with color. See, we have some smart people up here. Now, when we come up to this one, we're just going to make a, you know,
being
imagine there's
a
stem.
Colors. So poly is not any specific number, just a lot of the colors.
Okay. Imagine a specific stem here like this. Okay.
Hey, where
now we're
going
to add
educated?
Some white to this. Now, don't hear me. I'm going to add a little white to this and a little yellow. Same color mixture, okay? A little more yellow to it, a little bit of white. Okay. And now when I come up here, and let's take a tiny bit of red into that and tone it down just a bit. That's a bit bright. Then kind of gray it. What red will do is sort of gray the color so it's not so bright. And it's we don't really know the colors that Van Gogh really used, only in the sense that now this was just the same color we were using. We just added a little bit of white and CAD red medium to it. We don't really know because a lot of the paints that he did have faded and, you know, you can't really take what you see, unless you're seeing it in person, you can't really take what you see in a book. Now, see this light color? I'm coming in the middle of these dark ones, and now suddenly they're a little outlined, aren't they? Look at that. I didn't even have to wait till they dried. There you go, in like that. Now they feel a little outlined. Okay, so now you see what we've done, right? Now we're just going to come along in here in the middle of this. I'm using a little angle brush, and about every two leaves, I'm getting more paint. Okay. And there's a direction. If you print out the picture, if you go ahead and bother to print out the picture, you can see it's got some bigger leaves up here, some smaller ones, and I want you to see the direction of the petals. Here's a little one coming down here. He's going to have some vines. There's a lot to this picture. It is not that simple a picture. It looks simple, but actually there's a lot going on with that.
Do you think when he painted his, he outlined his instead?
No, he may have.
Since his is an oil.
His is an oil. He may have outlined it or not, depending. He may have outlined some and not others, you know? Just hard to know. But that's a very easy way. If you have to outline something to do it like that, that's very easy. I want this a little bit more of a lime green. Now, and I just want you to see what we're doing here. So if I came down here, you see that, like down here? I might come down here at the bottom and just do a little petal like that. And these angle brushes are perfect for it. Now watch, sometimes people have trouble making a leaf. And let me ask you this, how many people have ever seen a football? Think about that. Everybody's seen a football, right? Mostly, you know, some people in Europe may not have, right? But most of you probably not only seen a football, you've picked one up. Think about it, these leaves are like football shapes almost. So it's almost like two strokes. Here you've got an angle brush like this, all right? So you've got that little one here. I might be coming up like this. Let's say I've got a little stem coming down here like this, right? So I know I've got a little leaf coming off this stem here, and I've got another one coming this way. See that? And then I've got a little leaf coming, this imaginary stem, okay? Then maybe at the end of it I have a little leaf, see? So just that's kind of one, two, kind of that thing, and then we've got he had a little stem going up that way. We've got a little stem going this way. So that when you paint these in, okay?
Yes, American football.
Yeah, American football. We're sorry. It's American football. Well, I mean, but that's the shape. I mean, maybe you can think of a shape, you know, that you can relate to. But sometimes if you're trying to paint something, if you can relate to a shape, it helps. Now I'm going to add a little more phthalo blue to this and white. And now we're going into a little more gray blue. Kind of a gray-green color, tiny bit of yellow to that, okay? Now, this is more of a gray-green color because let's take a bit of purple and add to that. Now, the purple will tone that, the purple really tones that blue down, okay? So now I want to come back here and I'm going to add some more. Here we go. Here's some more of these leaves. Let's see, I'm just going to put an imaginary stem here. Maybe it'll help you to see that. Here's a leaf. Here's a leaf. Here's a leaf. We've got one coming down like this. And I'm just sort of, you know, adding some more. Let's see. And we'll put some flowers here in a minute. But we're just going to sort of say that there's some leaves here. And then, you know, coming up from the bottom like that. And, you know, we're just saying there's some. And we can outline. Now, if I wanted to outline, what I would do is I would take this, I'd take some purple, and I'd put some of these leaves in purple. Just take some deep purple, put some leaves in. I'll show you why. It's a different way of doing it. But we'll put some purple leaves in here, like that. Okay, now I'm going to come back into my light color and come into the middle of that. Now the purple has to dry. Let me get a second. Let me dry that purple, all right?
Okie dokie.
Okay, I'm going to dry that purple for a second. Ready?
Yep. All right, she's turned down. Yeah, Kim, Sammy's here. He's on the controls. He tries to be anyway, as much as he can. See what we got in the old readers. Or painting people. Let's bring her back.
Incidentally, before I forget, I'd like to tell you, let that sit for a minute. Our Wave and Water Masterclass, which is a special subscription on our website, gingercooklive.gallery. Can you back that out for a minute, please?
Yes, ma'am.
This is called Heartbreak at Sea. This is one of our lessons that we've got. This took a lot to put up. This was, I don't know how many videos. It is all completely now up on the website. So you Wave and Water Masterclass friends that are taking this, the website, all the lessons are up. And for you guys who would like to see what that's about, if you go to our website and click on this, anybody can watch
part six, which is on day two.
Which is on day two, and it's going to be just some water around the ship. So if you want to see what we teach in a Wave and Water Masterclass, we thought we'd give you a free preview of 20 minutes of part six. Anybody can watch that. If you just are interested, that might be fun. So we thought we would tell you that. Okay, so I'm back here to my leaves. And the Wave and Water Masterclass people, they get a new... it didn't really dry that much, John, but I'll just put a little white with this. This did not dry enough. That's okay. I'm just going to show you how you can use the purple to outline. You know, have an outline if you put the... See, then the purple, see how the purple is kind of outlining around the leaves. All right, let's put some flowers in, and then we can do more. And also, I know that these flowers up here and this side here, they have to be larger. See these ones? They're bigger. This is a big flower, so I'm just going to take a piece of chalk. These wild roses, we have those. They're really big. They're sort of a hybrid. They grow in Houston. They're not there yet, and we would have tried to show you some. But I'm going to start right about here and put a circle for a stem, and then I've got, here's a flower, kind of like little tooths, and then here's a petal, and then here's a little petal, and here's a petal, okay? So then we're going to have to say that this leaf here is bigger. We need some bigger leaves here like that. Okay. So
Chris is asking a question. Has ginger ever painted on granite for outside? I want to do something for my garden on a piece of granite countertop. What should I seal it with?
You know, I don't know. I really have no idea because I've never painted on granite. And I don't know if you put paint on granite, just a little piece somewhere, if you came back later, would it chip off? When you want to paint on glass or something outside, on your outside furniture, like a glass table, Home Depot's got some spray that you, and it's good for step two plastic, which is that, you know, mailbox plastic, and that nothing sticks to. And they have this spray, it's for glass and plastic, and you spray that first, let it dry, and then your acrylics will stick, and then you just go ahead and varnish on top of that. Use a matte medium and varnish on top of that. But I'm not sure about granite because I've never tried it. It's a good question. Just don't know. All right. So what I want to start with in the middle, I'm going to take a little bit of white. And I know I want some yellow. So I'm going to take, just going to paint that white in the middle like that. It's going to be yellow, but I'm going to paint that white. Then I'm going to take a little tiny bit of white and green and come down the, kind of in between here where my petals are. A little bit of green. Let's see, I'm going to rinse that off.
LeBlanc
now, our white, hang a second. There, our white is, let's see, where's the yellow oxide? We had that here somewhere. Yeah, okay. So our white is an off-white, okay? It's not quite, it's not buff titanium, but it's definitely a warm white. It's white with some yellow in it. So I'm going to take a tiny bit of yellow oxide and warm that white up a little bit like this. Now I'm going to come in here because it's what we'd call an off-white. All right, then you're going to go right over your... This is why I want you to dry it. Now, okay, John, go ahead with the question.
You know, LeBlanc, it says you can seal your granite with diamond wood finish, which goes on milky and dries clear. Apparently somebody has done it.
Well, you know, that's the wonderful thing about going live is that, you know... There's somebody out there that may have done something that you're trying to do.
And Nancy's done it too.
Has she? And she
yep.
says that that's what you do.
Yeah.
All right, so we're going to kind of square off the top of these. They're not quite as round as you'd think. A little petal. All right, so there's our first flower. We're going to put some texture into a second flower later, but we're going to come on over here. Now, this flower has a petal like this. Here's the round spot in the middle, and then they're coming around like this. He actually thought about how he painted the flowers. I mean, they're a shape. They're not just any old flower. So we're going to start with a little bit of white in the center, like that. Okay, and then I'm going to take that yellow oxide and white color to make my flower petal, and I want to make sure I have it big enough. I'm going to come out here like that with that, this one, and using just this angle brush. Now let's see, this one is sort of shaped this way, kind of has an angle to the side. Okay, so you're saying that this petal is coming around like that, and then you've got this one is kind of a boomerang shape. Say hi to our friends. We have a lot of friends from Australia. Did you guys know that they're having fall now? We're having spring and they're in the fall in Australia. And I was explaining to them that they really are upside down.
Oh, that's so mean.
I mean, maybe we're upside down and they're right side up, you know. And we're the upside down ones. But all right, so here's these petals coming out here like this. And got a nice one this way. And let's just bring this one around like that. So, all right, so that's, you know, get your general shape of your flowers. Now I want to just come back over here to this one's really pretty. It's got a nice big round one here, and it's got sort of an interesting shape. These shapes are, paying attention to these shapes, they're almost butterfly shapes, like that. So let's start with the white in the center. I'm putting the white in the center because I know I want the center to be at least this big. So if I do it that way, then I can see, kind of see what I've got going. And I don't know if John wants to zoom in a little bit. All right, so we're painting the flowers in again, like watching grass grow. Here's number four, John, for our trivia question.
Oh, excellent choice, excellent choice.
Okay, and this one is a little, almost more yellow.
Number okay. Four. That's a where.
Where? Huh, I'm aware.
You are aware. Well, okay. If I could say that person's name, that'd be a good question.
Okay. All right. That's a little tricky, isn't it, some of these? And this one's a little whiter right here, this little petal. So it's got a little bit more white in it. See the shape of this flower? It's just not some sort of little round flower. Each one of these petals has got a distinct shape. This is a good way to just practice shapes and direction, okay? So we've got that one. Now we've got a partial one coming. If this is a clock, straight down from six, about a finger's worth, we've got another one coming up here like this. Let's see if I can get a lighter piece of chalk. I'm going to try this yellow, see if this will show up. Here's some yellow. No, that's not showing up. Oh, we had some white chalk around here. Yeah, that's this one. Okay. All right.
Oh, here's a gimme.
Okay, so there's a little bit of round here, and then I've got a kind of a petal coming out like this. And then there's one that's going to be tucked around here like this. Okay. All right.
Here's a simple one that's appropriate for tonight.
Okay.
Of what nationality was Vincent van Gogh?
Oh, that's a good one, you guys. Da-da. What nationality? Nobody gets any hits. I can tell you what he wasn't. He wasn't from Russia. So there, you see? I've made it so much simpler.
You are a team player.
I know.
I don't believe he was from the South Pole either.
No, he was not from the South Pole.
See?
Okay.
You know, we're giving them the answer.
I know. We're trying to be helpful here. Everybody's had a chance to kind of type that in, right? All right, so that's
Gail says Dutch. Fada says Dutch. Amy says Dutch. Kim Sim says Dutch. Victoria says Dutch. Maureen says Dutch. Kathy says Dutch. Tanya says Dutch. Marty says Dutch. Manette says Dutch. Sylvia says Dutch. Dutch. Sue, Nicole, Jane, Christopher, Cuts,
Andrew. Well, we got a smart group here tonight, don't we? I mean, they're just pretty, you know, I don't know if that's
Sweden, Marie, back of the class.
Okay. No. If they get it wrong, don't call them out, right?
Oh, I shouldn't. Oh, okay.
All right. Sorry. Well, actually, we don't know. I guess you have to say what I want you to tell people what they've done, so you kind of have to. But
don't. Okay. Do, but don't. I got you.
You know what I mean? So, all right. So this
was
one's
not
a little
French
wider.
Either. That's good.
Yeah, he wasn't French. So
Ivan's right, south of the North Pole. He is correct.
Yep. Okay. So my answer is that he was Dutch.
But didn't stump anybody on that one.
No, it didn't stop anyone. But now I've got one for you. What nationality was Picasso?
Ooh.
Got one.
Bonus question.
What was it?
It's
what
worth
was Picasso?
5 extra points.
Yeah, let's put a little one off of here. He's got a little one off of here. It's a little
so
half of one here.
What is the nationality of Picasso?
Here's another big one down here from the corner. It's about, I don't know, about three fingers up. Well, how many was three fingers, John, again? I forget.
That would be an inch and a half.
Okay, so this is the outline. This is a pretty big one out here like this. Pretty big flower here. Okay, so we're going to do the white part here because this was really big. You know, yellow only paints over white, in case anybody's asking why we did it. So come on, you guys. What nationality was Picasso?
Gail says Spanish. Vidal says French. Becky says Spanish. Cece says Spanish. Now they're flying too fast. Portuguese. Italian from Susan. Kathy is Spanish. Sissy is Swedish. Zoe is Spanish. Gail Spanish. Sani's brush is Spanish. Sue Ellen says Italian. Kathy says Italian. Marty says American. Michelle says Italian. Peggy says Spanish. Tanya says
okay, so
Spanish.
I think that's
Chinese,
pretty good.
Portuguese. We're all over the place.
Okay, well, he happened to be Spanish.
Sí, señorita.
Happened to be Spanish. And he was a character. He was a real womanizer, that guy, Picasso.
Oh,
and,
really?
Oh, yeah, you know, I mean...
I didn't realize that.
You know, there are womanizers that are womanizers for the sake of just being womanizers, and then there are womanizers that really enjoy women, can't help themselves. You know, I think he was one of those. He fell in that category. He had a lot of kids from a lot of different wives, and all his ex-wives loved him. You know, he doesn't have any... You know, sometimes they all lived in the same house. It was sort of bizarre. So, you know, anyway, yeah, he was an interesting... And he could really paint. I mean, you see a lot of his abstract, but I mean, he could sit down there and paint anything as real as photorealism in a heartbeat. But he kind of, you know, was avant-garde. He could... And he came up with some kind of new ways of painting. And Picasso was besides Monet, was one of the first artists that actually became a multimillionaire. Monet didn't, but Picasso became a multimillionaire painting. He's the first artist, but you know, really make money painting. You know, the starving artist is not that far. You know, there's that kind of that. There's this myth. Not all artists starve, you guys. But there is this sort of starving artist myth going on, and because you know, like Van Gogh, Vincent Van Gogh, poor baby, he did sort of. He had a patron. He had a patron. Artists have, you know, kind of relied on other people to help them and, you know, to keep their craft going. All right, so while these nifty flowers are drying, let's make some bigger, let's make some bigger leaves back here. Let's make a real dark green here, a little bit of purple in it, a little bit of yellow and purple. And I want to make, these leaves up here were bigger. I made these too small. This is acrylic, so we can...
Just redo.
This is a do-over. Okay.
Alina would like to know, would Ginger agree that Van Gogh has a childlike style to his paintings?
Some of them were like that, and others were very sophisticated. He certainly had a unique voice. You know, he had a very unique voice in what he saw, how he saw the world. But do you know, like for instance, if you ever watch any of those singing shows, there'll be people that can really sing, but they don't care. They want the person that sings like no one else they've ever heard sing. So they don't care if you can imitate Johnny Mathis perfectly. They've already had a Johnny Mathis. They want someone else. And so that kind of thing, or Celine Dion. They're looking for the newest thing. And the thing is, and that's kind of true with art too, is that people are looking... They're wanting you to show us the world in a way we haven't seen. And once photography was, you know, pretty well on its way, by the late 1800s, there were photographs of stuff. And so even the artists used photographs as references, all right? So you already had a photograph, so then what could you do? How could you show the world something if you already had a photograph, all right? I'm going to come up here with this one, make a bigger leaf up here like that. I'm going to do one of these dark ones up here. Like that, maybe this way. Like that. Come up here with a couple of the darker leaves. How about in here like that?
So Wendy has joined us. Thank
Hi,
you, Wendy.
Hope everybody's doing all right in your family, you know? And Okay, so we need something in here. Okay, so let's make that split pea soup green again. Okay, and come back in here and let's just make that.
Sissy would like to know, can Ginger paint one of Van Gogh's self-portraits?
I could. Do you think anybody'd want to paint it too, though? I just wondered, you know. Wasn't sure if anybody wanted.
I'm going to do that strange guy.
Because he did a lot of self-portraits. They all did a lot of self-portraits. Okay, let's make some. Here's our background color now. And I'm just going to come in here like that and go over some of these leaves like this. Here's our little background color. I saved it out, right? Just a couple places. We're going to add a few little leaves like that. A lot of leaves in this picture. So I'm just going to sort of, you know, add a few more. And there's some highlights to this. People just don't appreciate. Let's see. Let's take a little blue, a little bit of white, a little bit of yellow.
Teresa would like to know, has Ginger ever done a pour painting, a pouring painting?
A what?
Where you pour the paint.
Yeah, there's a great, I've got a great one on YouTube, you guys, on how to use pouring medium. It's fantastic over there on YouTube. You guys should check it out.
YouTube. Yeah, if you've never heard of YouTube, it's youtube.com.
Yeah, I've got a great pouring medium one. Pouring is fun. This is where you just, it's like potluck, you know what I mean? You have no idea what you're going to get. See, now we're using this sort of light blue-green color. It's got a little purple in it. So now, please notice how we're layering the flower, the leaves. Everything's getting layered. You see, it's pretty easy, like that. Now, I haven't gone into the middle of this because we haven't dried it, but I want to do that, but I haven't quite done that. Let me dry this right here, and then we'll keep going with the leaves, okay?
Okay, you're quieted. Let's see, so I showed you, let me show you the, we have one person that has done the, been a wave in water, who was this? Caroline. This is a wave in water student. She did this painting. And she has really captured that. Ginger, where does this painting come from? Is this one from Australia?
Yeah, this is from Carolyn. She said we could use her full name, Carolyn Banks from Australia. Isn't that gorgeous? That's one of our Wave and Water Masterclass paintings, lessons. And I mean, I just think that's outstandingly beautiful.
She did a great job on that.
Her several months to paint it. I mean, these are not fast. We have some smaller Wave and Water class lessons that are, you can do in an hour or two. And then we've got some big ones. We've started to add some big ones too. Next month in April, we're really going to dissect. We're going to get into more of the nitty-gritty of the wave. Speaking of lessons that are sort of fun, if you like this one.
Nitty of the wave. I like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, if you like this one, this is one that's on YouTube right now. This is a Van Gogh, and you see this was his little poppies and with the little tiny buds and stuff. This is one of his. That's on YouTube. That's one you can certainly watch. And then if you like a challenge, I want to say on our website, gingercooklive.gallery, this is our pansy basket, and I think this is so pretty. We've got some pansies on YouTube also, some pretty pansies. And then I wanted to just show you, this is a marvelous painting of different ways to paint flowers, all right? And that's one of the lessons on our gingercooklive.gallery. We have over 295 lessons you can pick from one cookie to two cookie. Is this one up for sale, John, the rose one yet?
I think so. If not, it will be. I think it's cute.
Yeah, it's cute to be. And then we have this one is called a wild rose, and this is one you can buy as an individual lesson or rent for $4.95 if you like it. Or it's part of the 295 lessons on that we have because nobody wants to paint the same thing, so we have so many things. And this is one of my favorites, wild rose. And again, you can buy that as an individual downloadable lesson. So these are all flowers. If you're into flowers, this can be really fun, okay? Now, let's look at his picture again, which we put here. So you see we've got, let's go back to a little bit of yellow now and put some of these stems in, okay? And before I do that, though, I think I dried this stuff. Let me just mist my paint. I think that's what we're going to do. Mist the paint and do that. Now, I'm going to come in here like this. Now, I want the picture, the leaf outline, see? So all I have to do is just do that, and I've got an outlined leaf. Look at that. Isn't that cool? There's a lot of his paintings. He outlined a lot of stuff, and this is just sort of a fast way to get something that's out. you know, that's outlined. Okay, just like that. Here's this one. Now, you know, you could also just outline it too. That's all right. We understand. You could outline it like that.
Diana would like to know, does Ginger, have you ever done your own self-portrait?
Have I ever done my own? You know, I've never done a self-portrait. You know, John, that's true. I've done some portraits of my daughter. I've done some portraits of my grandkids. I've never done a self-portrait. Got that. Love that one I did of my granddaughter, Honey. Okay. I think this needs to be more of a yellow-green. So I'm going to change that color on this. Do you love how you can just add like a little bit of yellow in here? Look what happens. Like that. And it can change the green. I'll put a little white with it. Did you know you can mix on the canvas too? Don't panic if you don't get the right color the first time. It's really easy to just come back and change it. And I think I want this to be a little thinner in the outline here, like that. Okay, there you go, something like that. So, all right, so, and I don't like those, so let's fix these.
Melissa would like to know, what is it about Van Gogh that Ginger likes best? The color palette, the style? By the way, I love this.
Oh, thank you. I'm glad you like this. I was afraid everybody would just hate this. I thought it was pretty, and I thought, oh, they're going to think this is just too easy and not fun. But, I mean, I'm not curious as original. I really like this one. You know what I mean? I thought it was pretty, and I thought he had some, you know, great stuff. What I like is his color palette and the way he saw the world. I just really liked it a lot. And, you know, said that he suffered from migraines. And if you ever look at Starry Night, where everything's sort of swirling around, you could kind of see where that might be true, couldn't you? You know, that almost like a person that was suffering from, you know, little migraines. Remember, some of these leaves are smaller than others, okay? You've got some little tiny leaves in here too. So don't forget to just come back and, you know, plop in a few little tiny leaves. You don't have to get every last little leaf he did, but try to, you know, kind of layer them in here with the different colors. Put some more leaves in, see, like that. And that, you know, we need some running off of this way, like this. Okay, like that, something like that. Okay, so now, what are we going to do? We're going to do something about the, like the little stems. Okay, so we got a little bit of yellow, and yellow oxide. This was a lot of yellow oxide. Yellow oxide and yellow ochre are almost the same color, so just close enough. Okay, in case anybody's wondering, let's just brighten that up here. Now I'm going to add a tiny bit of purple to that after I brightened it up. Little tiny bit of purple, just
brighten it and bring
then
it back
I'm
going to
take a little bit of cad red medium into it too. Okay, there we go. A little bit of cad red. There we go. That's pretty. Just gingerize this a little bit. Now we're going to come through here like this and suggest a stem. Okay, a few little. You're just going to suggest some of these stems like that. Maybe we've got one here. Use just the get them real tiny. Here's a fatter one. There's kind of a wiggly stem around this one. Now this is a good color. Let's see, where else could we put this?
We've gone into gingerizing mode.
I think, you know, there's not a lot of it, but you know, you could come up here and, you know, add a bit here and there. There's something off of, there's a flower here for sure. Like that. Okay, so, all right, now I want to go into my cad red yellow and my cad red medium, about 50-50. And I want to put, let's see, I have this one right here. I'm going to say there's this bright kind of orange yellow center right there. And now this is the one I told you about. I thought I might try this yellow. This is called, what is that called? It's called Yellow Deep. And I want you to see that. Look at that deep, it's almost a sunflower yellow. I'm going to plop that on here like that.
See? Plop that on there.
The same thing. I'm plop that on there. And I'm going to do something a little different than I... There. I'm going to stop with that one because I want to do this differently. I want a lime green color. And then out from the center of this, using just a small brush, I want a little edge, almost like a halo ring of the green. Okay? Like that. Tiny bit of that green, and I want that around here too on all of these. There's a little bit of this green color. Before I put the yellow down, I wanted to put that, kind of put that down too quick. Same thing on this one. There's a just kind of this army green color, you know, the sort of, well, kind of the color of this background. Okay. And we're going to come around here like this and say there's this bit of green, and I might separate the petal right there. That's why I wanted you to save out some of that. We're going to say there's a little bit on this side too, a little bit more of this green here. And this one too, this little leaf back here, the little white, has got more of that green tone to it.
Minette would like to have more deep yellow in paintings.
Okay, I mean, that's good. More yellow deep in the paintings. We ought to be able to do that. Yeah, okay. So, all right, so I want to make sure that I've separated these petals out a little bit with the dark green. And then we're going to come in with texture. I'm going to show you how to do that with some texture, make this even more interesting, the second coat. I figured we'd just do this like that. And then while that's drying, let's take some phthalo blue and white and make this sort of soft blue color and put a tiny bit of cad red in it, like 1% to gray it. Now come along here like this. This one had, let's see, a little more white. This one had a little bit of this blue color shadow here, like that. Okay, and then back over here we had it on this one too. The only little bits of blue were on those two flowers. I think there was a little bit on part of this one. There we go. These ones, these three. Because there's really seven. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, and there were no blue here, no blue there, no blue there, but these ones had some blue right there. Okay, I mean, you can kind of see, I'm not making it up. Blue, blue, little blue there, blue there.
Yeah, we doubted you. Everybody was
well, just, I mean, you know, you're just wondering, you know, why is there blue? I give up. Why is there blue? Okay. And then here, let's come back here with a little bit of green. Here, there's a little bit of blue and white and yellow. And make this sort of bright green here. He had, right here, he had a little green leaf here like that. That was doing its thing. And there's a little bit of a green petal right there. A little leaf petal. Here we go. All right, acrylics dry darker, so sometimes you think you have all the stuff and then you turn around and you don't. All right, so that, whenever you're going from green to yellow, you've got to really rinse your brush. All right, so we're gonna come up in here and I'm gonna tap on this yellow color here, that yellow deep.
And you're still using your quarter inch?
I'm still using that. It's pretty much the go-to brush now. Okay, now this has a little white in it. On this one, there's a little bit of white on here like that. And this one's not as bright. You don't see anything on that one. Little tiny bit of the yellow deep on this one. Okay, like that. Those are the flower petals. Okay. Now, kind of cool, right? And then let's see, there's a little bit of green in the center, like
red,
this.
Yellow, make it brown.
Little tiny bit of green in the center. Little dot of green. Okay. Now, what could we do to make this more interesting? Haha. Okay.
Well, here's a question for you from Joanne. Sure. While you're thinking about what's coming up.
Okay.
Red, blue, and yellow make a brown. What would be a complementary color for brown?
Well, brown's a neutral, like black. Brown's considered a neutral. Okay, so brown is a neutral. In fact, you can just browns and beiges and stuff, and then pretty much everything. You know, it's contrast to brown. There isn't really what you'd call a complementary color to brown. It's just it's a neutral, like it's almost like a gray.
Because it's used all the primaries.
You know, and there's reddish brown. You know, but remember, there's red browns, blue browns, green brown. You know, different brown colors, right?
Right.
So now I'm going to just take some purple and outline a few of these, like that. Let's take a little purple and ultramarine blue. You could use black if you wanted to. He probably did. I think the color is more interesting. So here I'm going to outline that one and this, outline a couple of these. Just use the edge of my brush to just come around the outside and outline them. That's why we made it sort of a different neutral. Don't think we actually used any brown in this. I had it put out, but I don't think we actually used any. But again, you can come around and, you know, outline these. This would be where this would be the good use of a painting pen. If you found this tedious, you could do, like, for instance, like here. Here's our brush, and I love the angle brush for that. But if you found this tedious, you could certainly
You make it look so effortless, though.
You could certainly get the... Well, thanks, John. You certainly could just use a pen, too. And
Melissa's asking a question. Will acrylic paintings be around 200 years from now for future generations to appreciate?
Yes. Acrylic paintings will. The acrylics will last longer than oil paintings by far. You know what will not be around? Now that you've asked that question?
What will not be around?
The books that were written 100 years ago are still here, but the books that are being written today, the paper is going to disappear in the sense that it's not archival. And I was talking to some archivists one time.
Archivists.
They were explaining the books that were written, you know, in this in the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000.
We'll
50 years, they're gone.
Long live Kindle.
Long live Kindle. Well, and here's something you may not know. All right. For instance, everybody's all hot. Well, we have the computer. And then there used to be microfiche. Try to open one of those things now, right? There used to be microfiche.
Well, then I remember those.
Then we've saved it on this or that. Did you know that you can, not that anybody would want to, but I guess somebody might want to, you can go to the records and you can see how many cans of beans were eaten during the Civil War and so forth. But they can't do that because that was all written down. But they cannot do that for the Vietnam War. And why is that? Because...
They did it on a computer
that no longer can be opened.
Well, that was poor planning.
You know, because that, you know, you think that's all fun with these upgrades. This is version number 6. Well, what happened to version number 5? It was working fine with me. What are you people doing? What do you mean there's a version number 6? I liked 5. Stop it. I don't want to learn 6. But 5, I thought 5 worked better. You know, they're always trying to sell something, do something, right? And so you see these things happen where there's a, you know, that you, and, you know, they change the computers. They
yeah, try to read open. Your try to read your 5 1/4 inch floppies.
Remember yeah, I can't read that either. I'm just saying this. Okay, so now we could either go back. Now see our picture. This is pretty interesting. And the chalk will erase, by the way. But if you didn't want to erase the chalk, you could come back with a little background color like this and add a few more little layers to that too, like that. But all right, now that let's see, what is that? Is that chalk? Maybe that was. I don't know what that is. That's not chalk. That's something else.
We're going to fix it now.
We're going to fix it now. Whatever it was, it's annoyed me enough now where it's going to be fixed. I've got to have a light color right here, by the way. This was pretty light. Yeah, that's pretty. Okay, I'm going to show you how to take a little gel and pop these flowers out. Okay? So this is heavy gel, glass gel, like that. And...
I opened it earlier.
Thank you.
Okay.
So, you know, this is what, you know, I'm going to get a little bit. We don't need much. It's kind of old, but this will still work. See, it's kind of thick like that, right?
Now
I'm going to put that. Where are we going to put that?
How about a new piece?
Well, do I have another palette paper? I do. I think I do. I think I have another palette paper. Let's just put it on another piece of palette paper like that. There. Just move all this out of the way. Okay? Now, so, all right. So I've got it there, and I'm going to get some yellow. See, I think we were using yellow oxide, weren't we? To get that white color, and we need white.
Uh-oh, I lost my zoomer.
Uh-oh, lost the zoomer?
One moment, please.
Okay.
Please stand by.
I need a little more of the gel here, like that. The gel will dry clear. It goes on, it looks white, but it'll dry clear. You could use modeling paste, too, okay? So now, here's our little palette knife here. We're going to start with the white and the yellow, and we're going to make the color we want, all right? Like that. That's the color I want for these antique roses. And I'm going to take all that gel and I'm going to mix it in here like that. You can mix about 50% in, 50-50 if you want. Okay? And somebody said, if you can see, there's some gel that kind of mounded up funny. Make sure it's all okay. That's kind of old gel, but it still works, right? So you have mushed it all together, scraped and mushed. Yeah.
Now, is that the color it's going to stay?
Yeah, that's the color
it will
stay.
The gel doesn't add any color to it.
No, the gel dries clear.
Okay.
So now I'm going to rinse my brush, and I'm going to just scoop up some gel like frosting. Anybody that's ever frosted cake can do this, right? And I'm going to come on here like this.
Wait a minute, where are you?
I'm right here. Over here.
Let me get over to you.
Okay, and I'm going to make sure I have enough.
You're doing the big guy at the top?
Yeah, doing the big guy at the top. Make sure I have enough yellow oxide in it. And I'm going to come in here like this. Now, I've got this very thick, right? And then I'm going to make this second layer over the... Just scoop this up like peanut butter, you guys. and let it be thick. You could have done the center the same way, by the way, because you needed a second coat on here too. And each petal should have its own little bit of gel, okay? Because you're doing it with the brush, we're not putting it on with the palette knife, all right? So each petal has its own little bit of the gel, okay?
And the name of that gel was what again?
Well, this is just heavy gel gloss, okay?
Heavy gel gloss by Golden.
By Golden, but you know, so you're using
other people make the same thing.
Yeah, other people make the same thing. It's just some, you know, they make light gel, heavy gel. Now we're moving over to another flower, okay?
Gotcha.
And we're gonna come over here like that. This one's a little bit whiter. Here's my next layer. And the reason I'm doing it, I didn't do it just the first time, was I've got the shape I wanted first. I painted the shape I wanted first. Now I will go ahead and as I get around to the left side of the flower, the it's a little darker, but there's my flower like that. Now just come around here and do all of these like that. Okay. Now I won't do the blue one, but the blue ones I'll have to put a little blue color in. But I can come down here. Here's this one at the bottom. It's kind of, you can see, can you come down here a little bit down? Zoom back out and come over to my right.
Oh, okay.
This one, I want this one over here, and I want you to see it. See how this one in the picture is a little darker?
Oh, yeah.
Then say that one?
Yep.
Say that?
Yep.
Okay?
Yep.
So it's got a little bit of green woven into it.
It's almost like it's in the shadows.
Yeah, it's in the shadows, and so he made that one a little darker, so we got a little more yellow oxide with this one. And again, you want to just sort of scoop it off, scoop it up, and then lay it down. If you need to, here, I'll just pinch my brush so that I've got a nice little bunch of paint here, and just pull it on here like that. Pinch the brush, scoop up some like this. It's like a little shovel. And you could actually use this for all the leaves too, but I think it's more effective if the flowers are sticking up a bit. I think that's more effective. Makes it look more like an oil painting if you have a little bit of texture. Okay, and then I want to take some of that green like that, because what he did was he took that green, which is that green color from the background, which I told you to save a little bit of. Okay?
And hopefully we're gonna
come out from here like that. Pinch the brush each time, because now you're dealing wet on wet here, like that. And I'll pinch the brush, get some more, because I'm picking up the light color too, pulling it up this way, pulling it up like that. See,
isn't that cool?
I mean, that's very effective, isn't it?
Like that.
You know, and just maybe you make a few little veins coming out of this flower like that. You want it to get more detailed, okay? So there you go. Zoom back out.
Doing it
now for this one that has the blue in it. I'll take a little bit of the phthalo blue, and see, that's way too much. So here, let's take some white with that, a little bit of this yellow. Okay, so here's my blue color, and I think I want a little purple. I'm going to grab a little tiny bit of purple. There we go. Oh, that's pretty, okay? All right, now I'm going to just, I've got my gel here, so I'm going to pinch my brush and scoop some up. So I've got a little glob, and I'm going to come in here like that, almost like it's frosting. Let's take a little bit more white paint with it. There we go. Okay, like that. And scoop some up. Ooh, too much. Let's just put some white with it. Okay, like that. And then I think we had here on this one, we had a bit of dabs of that. And let's see, do we have any kind of the green?
Donna would like to know, could you use that gel like the stucco?
It doesn't, it's, you know, I've got a whole video on how to use gels, okay? If you look at my Van Gogh Starry Night, I tell you how to add it and make texture on Starry Night, okay? So if you haven't watched that Van Gogh video on YouTube on Starry Night, that's the one I would suggest you watch. I'm going to put a little bit of green in this one. You see here, kind of shadowed that like this. You can add color. And when it dries, you can paint, you can add color to it too, you guys.
So this is going to take quite a while to dry though, right?
It's going to take a little bit to dry. It's about 24 hours to dry, or to at least 12.
Okay.
So, I mean, this is really, now it's wet, see? But look how interesting that is. Now I'm going to take a little bit of the, this is the, that goldenrod yellow thing, and I'm going to just, I think I want some gel for that too. Where did I put the palette knife for that gel? Here, where's the palette knife for the gel? Oh, okay, put it back in. Here, I think I want the center. If I wanted the center to have a little bit, I'd start with its own little spot here. I don't have a lot of this gel left. You're right, John. But I don't throw out these jars because I buy a big thing of gel and then I use the jars for smaller bits. All right, so it's more economical when you buy a big one. So I've got some of that gold here and I'm just going to touch it and make the gold a little thicker too, see? I can come in here and just, it will make like little mounds, okay? Because remember, you can go 50-50 with the gels. And why would you want to use gels? For instance, if you're doing a palette knife painting, the gel is a lot cheaper than paint, and you can dilute it 50-50. All right, so that can be very handy.
Well, speaking of that, what's the drying time on the gel if you want to varnish?
About 2 weeks.
At least.
Okay, about 2 weeks. That's what Golden recommends, about 2 weeks. So here's a little more of the yellow paint here mixed in with the gel. See that? Now, and yellow is one of your more pricey colors, so depending on how big you were making something, see, I'm just going to plop in. See, it's going to be real thick. It's going to be real thick like that. And thick over here. And let's see, I want a little orange with some of this. Sometimes you don't want one color. You can add a little bit of something and it makes it look a little more interesting than if you just have the one. Okay? There we go, a little bit of orange on that one too, down over there. Now, my green, because I've got texture there, that's just that background green color. I can just plop it in the center here and it's still okay. You can do a little plopping and you're okay. So all right, so that's kind of cute, right? Interesting to know how to play with all the toys, okay? So now we can back out of this, and then what you want to do is, what I would suggest is you take your painting, turn it upside down, and turn the example over upside down like that. So then you start going, you look and you say, well, what else could I do, right? Could I put a little of this, some of this color here somewhere, a little bit on the outside of some of these leaves? Could I add a little more of the green to here? Do I put something here? You just kind of, and again, you're not trying to be just totally driven by what someone else did. I want you to get a sense of the design, though. Here's this little twig here. Here's one here like that. See? And then, I mean, I love that he did this painting. And I think that this is one anybody should be able to do. Anybody should be able to do that. And you'll learn a lot by doing it. How's that? And I can look at this and go, you know what I could do there that I don't have? So I could make that one petal I'm looking at that now, it's upside down. I'm going to come back over here on this one, scoop up some of my gel, which I don't have enough of. Here, put some gel out here. And blue paint, okay? Like that, a little bit of the blue. And right here on this petal, I want to make this petal bigger on this flower right here. And have a little more blue in there, like that.
Ray would like to know is, brush is in the, Jennifer's brush is gel and paint isn't that hard on the brushes. Basically, is the gel hard on the brushes?
No, it's not. Varnish is hard on the brushes, but gel is not hard, but you must wash it out. If you do not wash it out, it will dry as hard as a rock, okay? And then that will be it, okay? So, all right, so we've got a little bit of, some leaves coming up here. He had some that were just sort of all by themselves. They didn't have any outlines just coming up here. There was something above this, this flower right here. I'm looking, he had just something a little bit darker right there in this one. Little bit of leaf, but there were no outlines. There were some soft leaves, and then he had some harder leaves. Okay, so that's what you got to go back, because your acrylics dry darker, so you may think that you were doing okay with it, and then when you look, you're not. That's okay. You can come back, and do you need to lighten up any leaves like that? Do you need to come back up here and, reshape something? Okay, like that. Just kind of look around and see what you might want to do to your picture as you go back. And let's see, I want a little more white. Now look, I know we were into gels, but I want a little more white right there. And I can go right on top of that. See? And that still works. And the same thing here. If I needed a little more white, say up here on this flower anywhere, I'm looking at his picture. There was a little almost pure white on these two right there. I can touch that gel and still work. work it.
As long
and
as
I can wait till tomorrow.
You're touching real lightly right now.
Yeah, I'm barely touching. I can do it. I can wait till tomorrow. Okay. Now here's a little bit. If I wanted to separate this, these two, I can come in here with some background color, separate these two. I mean, you can. You've got a little room. I think that looks just weird. I'm gonna take that one out. Okay, like that. Just take that out and like that right there. But you've got some leeway. Even when you just have to be careful. That's what I would tell you. Just be careful. Right? Do I want to put a little, you know, color surprise in any of this? Now we say, could we gingerize it? What could we do? You know, we know that red and green are complements, and so we have a little red in there. Turquoise and orange are complements. So could you take some just pure cad red medium somewhere and add a bit of just a drop of, you know, just a few drops of red in here somewhere? I mean, he didn't, but you could. I'm going to do it anyway, just show you what I'm talking about. You can just, that's why I had you paint the red background, you know. Just sometimes a bit of red next to green, it can be really pretty. Just a drop here and there, just like that. Can be very attractive, I think. And some good contrast with the yellow and the blue. Let's make a dark green here like this. I'm looking at the picture. Do I want to come under here and make sure that this petal is very dark right in there? Can come back and I can touch that up. And then tomorrow I could come back up if I wanted to. If I needed to, I could come back up and reshape some of these petals right here where I did the gel. Could come around here and reshape a couple of those. See? So you're not just stuck because you, I guess that's what I'm telling you, you're not just stuck because you did the gel. You, if you're very careful, you can still work it because it stays wet for a while. All right, that would be the main message here. It stays wet for a while. I'm going to bring some of this yellow over the edge here like that. There you go, like that. And I think we're good. I would say that's a wrap, you guys. I don't know much more you could do with this piece. I think that's a good example of how you might paint this picture. I think I might make these a little bit smaller. This one flower right here, I'm going to cut it down right here. There we go. Yeah, just cut that down right there with some dark blue and yellow. Okay. Make a dark green right there. Cut that down. Okay. There. So see, that's just part of a little flower that's hanging out there. Yeah. Perfect. All right. That's our. Any other questions before we wrap it up? I'd love to, you know, finish off with a few questions. And I want to remind everybody that yesterday, we didn't tell you about the bread. All right, you ready for this?
Oh, yeah, wait, got to know about the bread.
Okay, so about
January,
my ex-husband had come by and he had dropped off a loaf of bread he was going to make sandwiches with and he never came back for it. So it sat there, we kept thinking, come get it. So then I think we showed you this about 3 months ago. So now what is this, April? So January, February, March, April, you know, so we're into 4 months, right?
Now it has been opened and a slice or two has been taken out.
There's no mold growing. It's still soft and squishy. It's not green.
And
it's
no, neither one of us will test it to taste it, and Sammy says no way.
So the joke is that every month or so we're just putting this in the studio every month ago, we're going to show you this magic bread. You know, it's almost like what was that stuff in the Bible where, you know, that the oil never went out of the jars or something?
It just kept pouring forever.
You know what?
Well, this is a bread that's going to keep on giving.
This is magic bread. So anyway, I just wanted you to see that because we're not making any comment other than, isn't that interesting? And look what I just did with the bread. I just smeared the picture.
How did you do that?
Because I touched the picture with the bread.
But can you fix it?
Well, that's a good question. Can it be fixed? Now remember, can it be fixed? Rinse, wipe, swipe. Yeah, see? Ginger fixed it. Are you impressed?
I am so impressed.
But because it was dry underneath. This is why you always stop and dry things, you guys. That's called a save as when you dry stuff, right? Otherwise, no, it couldn't be fixed. But we did fix it because...
And this is all part of the plan. We wanted to show you this.
Yeah, of course we did. You know, let's see, how did this little petal go here? Yeah, like this. There we go. Yeah, you can fix it. Like that? Yeah, sure. It's fixed. Huh? How cool is that? It's fixed. There we go. There's our little flower coming under there. You can zoom back out. So this is Vincent van Gogh's Wild Roses. I think this was wildly fun.
Wildly fun.
Was this wildly fun? Did you like our gas station promo? We're going to try to do more promos for these. And I hope you guys like that. And I'm seeing what else. I think I still need a golder, kind of a wild stem right here. A little bit of a... I want some colors here. There you go, like that. We needed something happening with some of this here. All right, so you know Ginger could paint on this for another hour, but we will offer restraint and stop. This was pretty bright right there, kind of made the bridge. That seven flowers, very nice design. I think this came out really well. Notice that this flower is darker. I think this yellow one down here is a little bigger. This center is a little bigger on this one. And there you go. See, that's it. That's it.
Well.
Yeah?
Yours looks better than his.
Oh, that's very nice.
Oh, the shirt. What about the shirt tonight?
Oh, this shirt. Isn't this a fun shirt? This one I got again. I bought a bunch of these shirts at woot.com. I've had this one for about 3 years. It's been washed a lot of times. And I just bought it because if I got paint on it, it would still look okay. So,
and
I mean, that's
what's
my
the
thought,
release for,
you know. Huh?
What's the release for this week?
Oh, yeah, the release for this week, yeah. So our members, okay. Now, remember, last night all of us did this. I hope you all did this and had fun with our lavender fields.
That's
I want to
gorgeous,
show you that.
Man. That's absolutely
so,
gorgeous.
I hope you've done that. Our release coming this week is going to be this copper pot and these eggs. This was painting.
Copper pot and eggs.
This was originally done in 100 years before Vincent van Gogh ever... was born. And this artist that did this, and we tell a little bit about his biography on our website, and this is our members' weekly release. Every week we overwhelm them with videos on things to paint, because not everybody wants to paint the same thing. And then, of course, this last week, I mean, the one that's still on there, this is what's up on the website now, if you haven't tried this. This is a great one. So remember, if you want to become a member of GingerCookLive.gallery, it's just $9.95 a full week, and that gives you access to all our lessons that are in our video lesson library, not the Wave and Water class, but the others. So whatever you feel like painting, just have fun with. And if you want personal art coaching and help, become a member. You know, under $30 a month, which is less than a tank of gas anymore.
You
can become a member of GingerCookLive.gallery and send me your artwork and get help. This is another Vincent van Gogh painting. I thought this would be fun to do maybe for Father's Day if he's got started on it fairly soon. And this is the old hat, and this will be another members release in a couple of weeks, okay? So we've got all kinds of fun things that are in store for everybody. And of course, we always appreciate your input on what you want to learn to paint. Here's our dice. We'll put the dice back.
Well, one thing we did notice, we're tracking our subscribers and the people who don't subscribe and who's watching what. And it seems to be a 50-50 split of people that are watching that don't subscribe.
Oh, and you guys, listen, it doesn't take anything to subscribe. Listen, when you hit subscribe on YouTube, nobody sends you letters. Nothing terrible happens to you, right?
You don't blow
up or
anything.
We don't sell your email address. Please subscribe.
We don't even know what it is.
Please subscribe to our channel. We really appreciate it. And if you're one of the ones that are watching and, you know, you want to help the artist out, because the more subscribers you get, this is how this works, the more your videos are shown. So you really help us when you do that. When you interact with us and comment, and when you share on Facebook, and when you and you put these in your playlist, these are all things that really help the artist that you like on YouTube get seen and... you know, it's a nice thing to do. And tomorrow I will erase this chalk here because it's still wet. I'll erase that chalk.
Don't do it now. I could paint over it,
but, you know, I won't. But okay, I could erase it. You know, you can erase a little bit of it, like right here where I had the chalk.
I knew it. See? You just can't leave it alone.
Well, I'm just saying you could erase the chalk tomorrow where you could, you know, you could erase it, right? Like that. There's a little thing. All right. Fun. This was fun. Hope you had a good time painting this, and we appreciate you guys. And art hugs from Houston, Texas.
Thanks, everyone.
Bye.
We will see you maybe over the weekend. Subscribe to our forum. Become a member of our forum. You get notified when I go live. John's journey continues with painting number 6.
We don't know what he's going to paint yet.
We never know.
He'll be the first to know.
I won't even know. I won't know until I sit down. Hey, good night, Sammy. Thanks for being at the controls, buddy. And I see you're packing up already.
Good night, John. Good night, Sammy. Good night, you guys.
Good night, everyone.